Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 71st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1224.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1083, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 2 terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing light deploy.
On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 72nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 15-6.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1081, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Also on Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 73rd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1226.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go SpaceX, go direct to cell.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the 21st time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Recently, SpaceX hit a major milestone with their Falcon rocket. They posted saying Falcon completes its 500th overall mission. Congratulations to the entire SpaceX team for making the impossible possible on the road to rapidly reusable rockets. There was an article posted during the week of potential major delays to the Axiom 4 mission. It says NASA and Axiom Space are indefinitely delaying a private astronaut mission to the International Space Station after detecting a new pressure signature in a part of the station that has had a long-running air leak. After that news, the International Space Station posted about when we could see the Axiom 4 mission launch. They said NASA, Axiom Space and SpaceX are reviewing launch opportunities no earlier than Thursday, June 19th for the fourth private astronaut mission to the International Space Station, Axiom Mission 4. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a whole load of Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 15-9 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 17th at 1:51 a.m. UTC or tomorrow, Monday 16th at 9:51 p.m. EDT. The following day, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 10-18 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 18th at 6:38 a.m. UTC or 2:38 a.m. EDT. The following day, and we should see the delayed Axiom Private Dragon mission. The AX4 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 19th at 9:46 a.m. UTC or 5:46 a.m. EDT. Another day later and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1023 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 20th at 7:32 a.m. UTC or 3:32 a.m. EDT. Later the same day and we should see a rideshare mission launch. The Transporter 14 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 20th at 10:19 p.m. UTC or 6:19 p.m. EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital Pad B launch site. Work also continues along the side of the highway near the launch site. The groundwork for the new Giga Bay is continuing with pile driving. There was a post about SpaceX activity we should see soon in Florida. It says, SpaceX has been given a limited entry right to prepare Space Launch Complex 37 or SLC 37 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station for Starship operations. Not long after that news, John Krause posted a picture of work already underway. It says, the legacy launch infrastructure at Cape Canaveral Space Launch Complex 37B was demolished this morning, paving the way for a new era of reusable heavy lift rockets in SpaceX's Starship to launch from Florida. Here's a look at the B18.1 test tank in the testing structure being prepared for more testing. Here's a look at Starship 38 continuing to be worked on inside Mega Bay 2. I wanted to share this insanely cool picture of a booster static fire that Musk posted. After the static fire test last video, Booster 16 was rolled back to the production site. As always, I have to say thanks to both Cesar Garcia and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.